and welcome to OT Over Easy. My name is Becca, and today I am all taped up and drawn on because we are talking about the flexor and extensor tendon zones in the hands. My scribbles here certainly are not perfect, but hopefully they will be good enough to give you an idea of where these structures are and what's in each zone. So let's crack on. Let's start with our flexor tendon zones. The way that I remember the flexor tendon zones is associating each numbered zone with the number of structures that we're concerned about in that zone. So if we look at our fingers here, the two structures that I have taped in my fingers, in blue I have FDS, flexor digitorum superficialis, and in black I have FDP, flexor digitorum profundus. Closing the blinds to try to help with the visual. My little green line that you can just about see, that is the edge that separates zone 1 and zone 2. Zone 1, which is distal to the insertion of FDS, contains one structure, FDP. Zone 2, which starts down here and goes to the insertion of the FDP, that contains two structures, the FDS and the FDP. Zone 3, which is this piece of tape here, is where you also have the intrinsic muscles, your lumbricals and your palmar interossei. I didn't make those individually out of tape because that would have gotten far too messy, but that's our third set of structures we're concerned about. So zone 3, three structures, FDS, FDP, and now the intrinsics as well. Flexor tendon zone 4 is going to be right here. It's your carpal tunnel. And our four structures that we're concerned about in the carpal tunnel is the FDS, again, in blue, the FDP, again, in black, your median nerve, which I've got in orange there, and your FPL tendon, flexor pollicis longus. Zone 4, four structures. Then zone 5 is just proximal to the carpal tunnel. So again, quick review. Zone 1, one structure, FDP. Zone 2, two structures, FDP and FDS. Zone 3, three structures, FDP, FDS, and the intrinsics. Zone 4, the carpal tunnel, four structures, FDP, FDS, median nerve, FPL. Zone 5 is proximal to the carpal tunnel. That is how we label the zones for the fingers into the hand. Now the thumb kind of lives by its own rules, and that is true for both the flexor and the extensor side. For the flexor side, we are using our joints essentially as our cutoff points. So zone 1 is going to be distal to the IP joint. Zone 2 is between the MCP and the IP joint, and zone 3 is proximal to the MCP joint. So it's this space between here before you get to that carpal tunnel. And that is often denoted as T1, T2, and T3. So this over here with the fingers, these are just called zone 1, zone 2, so on. This is zone T1, zone T2, and zone T3. If you need to have a closer look, just pause the video here. When we flip over to the extensor zones, these I think are quite a bit easier to remember. When it comes to the extensor zones, all you need to remember is that your odd number zones are on joints and your even number zones are between joints. So here are my odds are in orange and my evens are in pink. So let's follow them down. We've got zone 1 at the DIP joint, zone 2 over the middle phalanx, zone 3 at the PIP joint, zone 4 over the proximal phalanx, zone 5 over the MCP joint, zone 6 in the back of the hand, zone 7 is the wrist, zone 8 is proximal to the wrist. So it's just real easy, joint space, just going all the way down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Easy like that. The thumb is following a similar pattern. It's just the numbers are slightly different because there's a different number of joints in the thumb as compared to your fingers. So here at the IP joint, we have zone T1 over the phalanx, T2, MCP joint, T3, metacarpal, T4, CMC, T5. So it's still joint space, again, just slightly different numbers because of the different number of joints, but it's T1, T2, T3, T4, T5. Knowing all of the different kinds of injuries associated with all the different zones is an advanced practice level skill for hand therapists. You do not need to know all of that as an entry-level occupational therapist. You should not be asked that on an entry-level exam. However, there's two that I think might come up that you probably should know. And that is going to be for extensor zone 1 and extensor zone 3. For extensor zone 1, if you sustain an injury in this zone, you're going to get a mallet injury or a mallet finger. And for extensor zone 3, if you sustain an injury there, you might develop a boutonniere deformity, which is going to be flexion of the PIP joint, extension of the DIP joint, like this. So again, zone 1, mallet, zone 2, boutonniere deformity. And those are the only two that you need to know for entry level. And that's all you need to know about the flexor and extensor zones of the hand. If you're studying on a deeper level for a hand therapy exam and would like me to go into a little bit more depth, let me know in the comments below. I might make that in a separate video another time. But otherwise, if you have any other entry level topics you'd like me to make a video on, drop them in the comments below. I hope this makes understanding the hand a little more easy, and happy studying! Hello and welcome to OV. That's a good start.